everyone. The state of Utah passed a bill recently regarding a proposed flag change. We're going to show you this bill and talk about the key points in it. It's a pretty exciting time right now regarding U.S. state flags. After Mississippi changed its flag last year, this year we have the states of Massachusetts and Utah looking to change their flags. So let's take a look at the Utah Senate Bill 48, which lays out the details. The bill creates a state flag task force as well as establishing a commemorative state flag. So basically, we have two separate things going on, a possible new state flag, plus a special commemorative flag, which celebrates the fact that 2021 marks the 125th anniversary of Utah's statehood. We'll be talking about the commemorative state flag towards the end of the video, which is something we're pretty excited about, so be sure to stick around for that. But for now, we're going to stay with the main topic of the bill, which is the process for a new state flag. Staying on page one, they mention public input for the submission and assessment of flag proposals. So it looks like members of the public will be allowed to submit flag proposals, as was the case with Mississippi. On the next page, it goes through some technical stuff, including definitions, but this right here stands out to us. Principles of good flag design. Oh yes, we like seeing that phrase. On page three, it tells us there will be 9 people selected for the task force. Most of them will be selected by various lawmakers. One of these people that will be selected really stands out to us. One of the members will be an individual who is a member of a vexillological association. This should be good news for those of us who love great flag design, and hopefully this member will be able to steer the other members in the right direction when it comes to good flag design. Another individual will be a representative of the Board of Tourism. This should also be good news because this may also lead to a good flag design and possibly the creation of an iconic flag that can be used by the state as a selling point. Quite frankly, the current flag doesn't lend itself very well to good branding, and not many people want this flag on various merchandise such as t-shirts, refrigerator magnets, and so forth, or even to fly the flag itself. So we think it's a good sign that they're looking at this from a tourism and economic perspective. Here is the flag of Utah alongside the flag of Arizona, Utah's southern neighbor. Arizona has a great flag which works far better from a branding and marketing perspective than Utah's flag, which is among about half of the 50 U.S. state flags which have their state seal on a solid field, most of which are dark blue shade, just like Utah. Returning to the bill, page 4 tells us that by September 15th, the task force must put forward up to 10 flag proposals, and then a process will be created to enable public input into the designs. This may involve online polls, or perhaps they'll conduct surveys in Utah, and so on. We're not quite sure yet what the exact process will be. Then by November 1st, the task force must submit a written report giving their recommendations for a new flag. On the next page, it states that the task force may designate the current flag as an official ceremonial flag. We're not exactly sure, but we think they included this as a way of officially recognizing the current flag going forward if the flag does indeed change. And if the current flag remains the state flag, then of course this won't be necessary. Staying on page 5, we can see that wonderful phrase again, principles of good flag design. And here it goes through what all you flag lovers already know about and what we talk about so much on this channel, which are the 5 basic principles of flag design. The bill mentions all 5 principles, which is certainly a relief to us. Those of you who followed the Mississippi flag saga will know that they conveniently left out principle 4, which states that flags shouldn't have lettering or seals. And that's how we ended up with the Mississippi flag having the words "In God We Trust," which was something that didn't please us or many other flag enthusiasts. So with all 5 principles taken into account for Utah, hopefully we'll end up with a great flag proposal. The bill doesn't mention what will happen after the task force recommends a final design. We don't know if there will be a referendum, but we think it's very likely. We don't think the lawmakers of Utah will pick a design and designate it as the new state flag without putting it to a vote of the people. The question is, what will the choice consist of in the referendum? We think there's a good chance the people will get a choice between keeping the current flag or choosing the design recommended by the task force. Again, going back to Mississippi for a moment, the people only had the choice of accepting or rejecting this one design because the old flag was retired due to the controversy surrounding the Confederate battle flag. Because the current flag of Utah doesn't have controversial symbolism, we think it's likely the people will have the opportunity to vote to keep it. So while having a choice of keeping the current flag or choosing a new one would be a big improvement on what was offered to the people of Mississippi, we would like to see at least 2 referendums. We think the people of Utah should have an official vote among the potential new designs. We think the task force should pick 2 to 3 flags instead of just one and have an initial referendum among these. Then the winning design in the first referendum should go head-to-head against the current flag in a second referendum to decide what the state flag is going to be. Our suggestion is very similar to what happened in New Zealand back in 2015 and 2016. The people had a first referendum with a short list of 5 new flag proposals, which were chosen by the flag consideration panel. The winning flag in this first round then went up against the existing flag in a second referendum. As we can see, the existing flag of New Zealand won the second referendum fairly comfortably with almost 57% of the vote. So let's return to Utah. At the end of page 5 of the bill, we now turn our attention to the commemorative flag. Page 6 describes the flag design in technical detail, defining all the flag's color shades. Page 7 continues the technical description and describes the layout, and also begins to describe the flag's symbolism, which continues into page 8. So rather than reading through all of this, we're going to show you this flag. And here it is. This flag was designed by Jonathan Martin as part of his organization for a new Utah flag. We highly recommend checking out the organization's website because it has a ton of information about this flag and also has a bunch of other designs Jonathan came up with. We're really excited to tell you that we're going to be making a dedicated video about this flag. We were actually in contact with Jonathan and he gave us some really cool extra information about the flag that we'll be sharing in that video. So hopefully we'll have that video up within the next couple of weeks. So be sure to subscribe to the channel for that video, and of course we'll be updating you guys on the developments that happen in Utah this year, as well as in Massachusetts. And as ever, we'll be publishing many more flag related videos that you don't want to miss out on. So what do you guys think of the flag process in Utah? Does Utah need a new flag? What do you think of the chosen commemorative flag? Let us know your views in the comments. Until next time, bye for now, and thank you for watching.